It's Sunday the 13th of September. Yeah, it's really back English now, all these haws here turning scarlet. So this is the bottom peg. Those willows opposite, some willows downstream. Well, I came down to make a video of Cunnell Hall, expecting it to be busy and that. There's nobody here. And this bottom peg here is apparently quite difficult to get on. So I thought, well, rather than go to Fornington, it's a lovely day, it's the 13th of September. It's slightly overcast, but the forecast for the rest of the week is terrible. Gales and rain. So there's no wind. It's absolutely peaceful. The river is quite pacey here, so it's big weights, and check the bait frequently when you get washed off. I've never fished here before, so it's a sort of shot in the dark here. We'll just have to see what comes of it. Anyway, the rods are ready to go in now, so hopefully we'll get something on. It'd be nice, that. With the pace of the water, the bait runners have to be quite tight, otherwise it just pulls line off. So you have to keep your eye on these rods, because I suspect if you got a fish on and it made its way downstream, everything would happen very, very quickly. Being wrapped around and rod in the river if you aren't careful. Yeah, see what I mean. It's only 4:15. I've only been here 20 minutes, and the bottom rod was just about away. Anyway, whatever it was, it came off. Just too slow to get to it. beautiful fish. I just meandered off for a pee, and next thing I know, the blooming top rod was off. My God, I thought I'd lost it. Unfortunately, the bait runner was lucky enough to take the fish, but that is an absolutely stunning fish, isn't it? It's barbel gore. You don't get much better than that. Look at the colours on it. Beautiful colours. Lovely barbs, or barbules, in the eye. Well, having missed one earlier on, that is a real bonus, is that. And hardly, there isn't a mark on it, and a dorsal finish, just beautiful. Keep my eye on this bloody bottom rod here, it'll be off in a bit. And it's now what? 6:10. Let's put him back in. It takes a tremendous if you grab the rod immediately, because you're fishing a long way downstream, though, just pulls. And I just felt that go. It's a great shame, but it's exciting fishing. It's what barbel fishing's all about. Well, it's now 7:30. We had 3 massive wrap rounds and only managed to land one fish. If you're distracted for 1 second, you know, pouring a cup of tea or going for a bit of toilet relief, they're off. And of course the water's going like a train down here. So it's been very different to the usual summer fishing, where you're just lobbing it into very slow moving deep water. These fish here grabbing off like hell. So we've lost 2. Got 1. And there's loads of tackle being lost in here. Every time I cast and put and pull in, I bring in line in and feeders and shots and all sorts of things. So people are coming down here with seemingly inadequate gear. On the off chance that I don't catch anything else, I'll see you on the banks another night. And good for now. Take care. Goodbye. Somebody's dumped a set of waders here. Obviously, been here a fair while. I suspect they leak like a sieve, which is where they've been left. Nevertheless, should have taken the blooming things home with him, chucked them in the bin.